Guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Scrap Queen and today I like to show you my newest design team project for Country Craft Creations. Let me first tell you which collection I used. And I used the brand new collection Garden Goddess. And it's really awesome. It's very light. It's yellow, green and pink. And the colors are just really nice, fitting all together. And it's a very flowery collection. And I really love the girls in it and the clock. And, well, everything is really nice. I totally used the 12x12 kit. So they are 16 sheets plus the sticker sheet. This is what I have left. And I used the 8x8, but not all, but the most of it, it is the 16, the 12x12 papers, and I don't know exactly how much for the 8x8, but definitely I used those two. So let's get into I created. First of all, I had a cigar box and I recently got from my father-in-law, and I really thought this will be the perfect size for this project. So I first cover up the cigar box with design paper and made a closure on it. So let me first give a good look to the cigar box. So this is the top. As you see, I used the big design paper, and I used a bronze element, and I believe this was from an old cabinet, and I had this very long time in my stash, and now I totally thought this was a perfect for this occasion. Then all the way around I used design paper, of course, as you can see, all the same. And on the bottom, I used this paper. So I first cover it up with white, and then I cover up with design paper. And on top here I used this knob, a bronze knob I believe, or a pull for a handle or a drawer. I thought that was perfect. So it ties together with a seam binding closure, and it's very easy to open this up. And like this. So I thought that will be fun. So when you open this up, inside we have the album, and in the lid I also created a big pocket so you can put your photos in if you like. I already make two cards in it, two leftover cards. I thought, oh yeah, I need something to put in this pocket, but thank God I had something left. So these are already in here in this pocket. And then inside there is, of course, the album. So let me grab it and then let me show you. Okay. Oh, and this is the inside also, with yellow and pink and the lovely flowery papers. So let me put the box away. And let's see how this album looks like. Let's first get a little bit closer. Yeah, this is perfect. Alright, so this is the front of the album, of course. Again, I used the same image, Garden Goddess. I kept just inside, and I only put a nice little ribbon bow on with a sparkle heart in the middle. I thought that would be enough because the paper is really busy enough. For the first time I used canvas for the spine. It's the very first time that I use it, and it's a nice light beige color, and I thought it would be perfect to use for these papers. And I did fussy cut a few flowers and a leftover clock and this sentiment, and I thought it would be perfect to cover up the spine so it would not be boring. And on the back I used this paper and a sticker in the middle and some white lace to cover up the boring edge. So yeah, that's mainly the outside. So it's really simple, but I really like it because the paper is really busy enough. So let's get in. Alright, so on the inside cover I made it pretty flat. You can, let me see if I have something left. Oh yeah, here's some little piece. I don't have much left, but anyway. These are actually two photo mats, and but you can put anything in it, of course, but the meaning is that you put your photo in here, so when you open this album you can really see right away your photo. So, but if you want to put something else in, that's also of course a possibility. So I have made two little pockets, and you can put anything in it if you like, but I think for a photo it will be a perfect. So sorry for the light that reflects on the acetate pocket, but love it. Okay, let's go to the first page. I made 5 pages in this album, and the meaning was all 5 the same, but I made 1 mistake, so they are 4 exactly the same and 1 a little different, but that was my mistake, and you know me, I want to use everything. Okay, so the first page is just a simple big pocket, and I always love pockets, so you can put anything in it where you want, but I made a big tag in it with a card from the sheet. I used the sticker on top, so it's a nice pull-out. I use my crocodile corner jumper for the top to give it a nice extra touch. And on the back I put some stickers on it. So this is the top page. Then we flip this to the left, and then we have again a pocket, but then of course it's smaller. I made a big tag in it, did a little fussy cutting here, and use my leftovers. Also a little sticker, and this is the a card from the sheet. Then this is a closure, and it opens up with this brown anyway. Then you see first this page, and I cover up first the leftover strips, and then a big piece and a sticker on the bottom to give it a nice extra look. Then this flips open, and then we have just a simple page with a cover up with a nice strip, and same here. I really like using the strips, and if your design paper is not wide enough or high enough, you always can use these strips, and I always like that, to use all of my papers instead of cutting a new paper and then leave all the leftovers behind in an envelope and never gonna use them again. No, I really want to use everything. Here I put some nice stickers on. Here I use a strip. Here is a strip. I love using the strips. Then this closes again back with this. Yeah. I think at the end of the album I think I know the word. Okay, then again we have a big pocket, and I used again the strip and this nice design paper, and I created a nice big tag also using the strips and the tag. And my tip is always make your tags on the very end of your album. If you are making an album, then don't put any tags or booklets in it. Just wait till the end, and then with your leftovers you can do so much, and then you don't have that much paper left over. So okay, then we turn this to the left, and again of course we have this small pocket where I made this tag in. I just love making leftover tags. That really gives a nice attached to a card or tag. Then we are going to untie this bow, this ribbon. Nice big place for photos. When we open this up, this I covered completely with design paper. And then in the middle, I also use first my leftovers and I created just a little tuck spot. You can put a nice photo in here, but for now I use this to put this tag in. So what a nice idea to put your photo like this in here. Then on the left side, I also used the leftovers first, and not only to cover up the page, but just making a little three little pockets. So that's also a nice way to use your leftovers to give it a little activity in your page. Okay, so let's tie this again. Then you must leave the blanket. Then on this side again, oh yeah, this is my mistake page. I cut the wrong way. But, well, you know me, it's not the scrub queen way to use another sheet to make it over and over again. Nope, we just fix it. So I made a swing tab here, and then you can open this up. And it's a nice attach to put a nice photo on the back, or you can write something down. So it's just an extra touch. Then on the back, of course, a big pocket with this tag I made. Put some little stickers on the back and it's done. Really easy, fun to do. Then we flip this open. And oh, first the pocket. Don't forget first the pocket. Look at this. Amazing. I just love these tags. So cute. And I made those tags myself because I don't have the tags from Graphic 45, so I made them myself, really easy. And I don't film it, but it's really easy. I'm going to tell you. You just cut out a wound punch, and before you glue the wound punch on it, you are going to use a corner chomper, not corner. Oh my gosh, corner punch. So you do that first, and then you glue the circle on the wound one you did punched out, and then you will have your tag. So yeah, it's really simple actually, but that is how I make my tags. Okay, so we open this up, and then we open this up, and then we have here a nice tuck spot where I put a nice tag in, and in the middle I leave it white. It's really a nice spot to write on or put a nice photo on. And this is the card from the sheet. And then here I used the border from the strip page. And then this opens up. And then here I just made two photo mats. And if you have a photo, you can stuck it behind here. So you don't have to cover up this piece. So you can put a photo on here and then just a little on the back, and you also can use this as a photo mat. And this page, of course, is a complete page where you can write on or put photos on. All right, so let's tie this back. And then for the next, well, that is not very neat. Let's do it again. Okay, yeah, this is better. This is way better. Well, yeah. Then we go to the next page, and of course we have again the big pockets, and I really love this design. Using your scraps, and it will turn out amazing. Oh, well, keep it in frame. I really love this page. This design of paper, really the yellow pops out. And after that I made this card, and on the back a few stickers, really nice. Then we flip this to the left, and again a nice small pocket. And look at this tag, amazing. Really love these cards, these tags, cards. really cute. Then we go to the next. We're going to open this. And here we have a full page where we can put loads of photos on. And here in the middle also a big page with nice design paper. And here again I use some leftover strips and make a few little pockets out of it. Look at this. So cute. And this is actually a sticker, so I only put some white on the back to give it a little stability. And that fits perfectly on here in the back. And then on this page I made a little belly band and a little stopper. And then this is also a sticker, so it's perfect to make a nice tag with it. And then this is the stopper to keep it all in its place. Okay, so wrap it around. Okay, then again on this side we have a big pocket and I used a big garden goddess word, and again some leftovers to make it a nice page all together. I really think it fits perfect together. And then we created a nice big tag for it, and on the back you can put a nice photo on, or you can write down, but you can put loads of things in these pockets. Then we come to going to the left, and again a nice big nice small pocket with a nice tag in garden goddess. Also always use the leftovers, really cute. And on the back, oh, this one I did some design papers on, I think for the left. The leftovers, I use it all. Gosh, I use it all. Yes, I did. Then we untie this ribbon. Here I created just a little tuck spot again. I had not enough space for this, so yeah, it's a nice way to create just a little tuck spot. Always nice to do that. Then we go to the right, and again here also a little tuck spot. Just a nice place to put your photos or your cards or tags in. And in the middle a big sheet where you can put a lot of photos on. And on this side also created a nice pocket. This is a sticker and I created a nice card with it. So nice to use all the stickers from the sheet. Then this goes back like this, and tie this. And then on the back from the inside cover I created also a photo mat. So this is one big photo mat where you can put a nice big photo in all the way down till here. So yeah, that is a perfect nice end to end your album. But you're not going to be on. If you don't want to put a photo in, you can put anything in it, of course. But it's a nice tight pocket with a nice acetate, as you can see. All my lights. All right, so yeah, I hope you like it. And keep it. I hope you like this. It was a really fun project to make. I'm not used to make all pages the same. I'm really not used to, but sometimes papers are not made for too much busyness like I normally do. So I wanted to make it quiet and simple and easygoing that really adjust for the papers. So that is why I choose that. So yeah, thanks for watching, and please follow my tutorial. The tutorial will be soon available on my YouTube channel. And give me a thumbs up if you like this, and please check all the materials at www.countrycraftcreations.com. And yeah, that was it. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.